I'm Blake X, and this is another nuclear reaction. What is up, survivors? Hope everyone's doing great out there. You know, I really wish I had more time in a day, more time in an evening or night, whenever it may be, to get more filming done, because there's so much I want to do on this channel. There really is. I'm really enjoying this. I really am loving what I'm doing here with these reactions, and it's really good because it never feels like work to me. Sure, it is time consuming. Sure, I get frustrated when I don't have enough time to get a video done because I work full time in addition to doing this channel. So, you know, I pretty much have a full plate and a full schedule 24/7. But regardless of that, I genuinely enjoy doing these videos. I just want you guys to know that. And in return, you guys show me so much support and so much respect. And the nuclear family is just a really amazing thing, man. And I really love it. But yeah. There's a lot of stuff I have planned for this channel, a lot of stuff that I want to, you know, get on and really put out for you guys. So part of that is getting to the requests. That includes the patron requests, which if you don't know, patreon.com/nuclearreactions, no pressure, but if you want to join, become a patron for as low as $2 per month, you can get access to all kinds of exclusive content, never before seen video clips, unreleased reactions that you'll never see on this channel. Check it out if you're interested. But yeah, so patron requests, I'll be getting to those, getting to requests that go on the infinite list, which, by the way, putting in a song request, that's always going to be free. The Patreon is just one more option. It's just one more way to do that, to guarantee your request. But you're totally free to make a request in the comments and get it put on the infinite list, and I'll try and get to it as soon as possible. So there's the Patreon, there's the infinite list. So those are all reactions that I want to do. There's also the Deathcore reactions. Camp Deathcore must be appeased. There's also the other reactions that I pick, including reactions to new singles that dropped. There's a couple that I want to get to that I still haven't had the chance to tackle. So there's a lot of stuff going on. And another thing is my power metal journey, because I'm slowly but surely discovering that I really like this genre and I really don't know much about it. I really haven't explored much of it because I had a very closed mind toward it in the past, unfortunately. And so a lot of this is all brand new to me. So, you know, today I'm going to continue that journey, and I'm really excited because I'm really developing a love for power metal. And in particular, I really, really enjoyed the first and the last Blind Guardian song that I heard and that I reacted to on this channel. So this is another one called Wheel of Time. A few people let me know in the comments on the last one that there was a song that was based on the Wheel of Time book series, fantasy series, for those who don't know. So I think that's really cool. So this is going to be my second Blind Guardian song. Now, I'm already feeling like this is going to become one of my favorite bands. Like, at least in my top 20, if not in my top 10. Because I genuinely really enjoyed that song. And you could go back and check out that reaction if you want to see for yourself. But I found that to be an incredible song. Very memorable, very engaging, very good energy to it. Really good experience hearing that one. So I can't wait to see what they do musically with this one. And this is going to be an almost 9-minute long song. So I better get to it. By the way, the Patreon thing, the link to that will be in the description beneath this video. You can also join the Facebook group, The Mushroom Cloud, and check out the merch store, Ye Olde Nuclear Shop. Those links will also be in the description. All right, man. Blind Guardian. Who knew? Who knew I would end up liking power metal? And if you don't know, black metal is like my primary go-to genre, so this is particularly surprising for me. But anyway, okay, Wheel of Time. Let's check this out in 3, 2, 1. Go. Wow. Whoa. I love that Eastern influence. I gotta make this louder. okay, I was not expecting this at all. I was not expecting any of this. I mean, I was expecting it to be good. I had a feeling I was going to like it based on the last song that I heard. But I was not expecting the intro with the Eastern instrumentation, very Egyptian sounding, you know, very cool way to begin a song. And then I was definitely not expecting it to go into like this epic orchestral type of place, which it's doing now. I think that's fantastic, man. I don't know, man. This is going to be yet another video where I'm just like unable to like pronounce words or speak properly because like I'm having such a, you know, my mind is so blown over the music, you know. Man, what the, I can't believe I never gave power metal a chance. Anyway, I'm just going to stop stuttering right now and get back to the music. Let's continue. Love this guitar right here. Doesn't light up. So I really love Hansi's vocals, by the way. And also, I don't think I mentioned this. Well, that's because I didn't know at the time, but I discovered after listening to that first Blind Guardian song that I already heard Hansi once before because I listened to this one song by Orphaned Land. That was the song called. It had a music video. It was a really good song. It was called Orphaned Land. It's right on the tip of my tongue, but I can't think of what it is. Like Orpheus, that's the name of it. Sorry, guys. Yeah, I haven't heard it in a while, but I did hear it a few months back, and I really liked it, particularly the vocals. And I didn't realize that the guest vocalist on that song was Hansi from Blind Guardian. So I got to go back and listen to that song as well. But yeah, I really love this dude's vocals. Really love the whole song. Really love the orchestral element going on here. This is fantastic so far. Let's keep it going. Oh, man. You gotta be kidding me. I love this music so much, man. Maybe I really should tie my hair back, as some people have suggested. You know who you are. Because I'm constantly untangling my earbuds from my hair. But whatever. Anyway, I'm not going to talk about that. I want to talk about this. This was excellent. This was like an epic journey, man. Like, this was just... It's like... And you know what? It's like... I try and be very fair and balanced in my reactions, but whenever it comes to Blind Guardian, I guess I'm just going to be heaping praise on them, because like I really had no problem at all with this. There's nothing I could really pick apart. There's nothing musically that I didn't enjoy. What I will say is that I didn't like it quite as much as the last song that I heard, but it comes pretty damn close. Imaginations from the Other Side I liked slightly better, but you know, it's a close call. Yeah. I got to do like a power metal week or something, you know. But no, that's, I shouldn't do that. That's too self-indulgent of me. Because I want to get to you guys. I want to give you guys what you want. And I want to really focus on the infinite list in the coming days and getting to more of your requests. I hope you guys know that's always very important to me. And, you know, like I said, that'll always be free. That Patreon tier, you know, to the $80 tier, if you really want to bump your request up and guarantee that it gets done, that's just a way to make sure that, you know, if you absolutely really want me to get us to a song that you have requested really soon, that's how you do it. But you are also free to just leave your request in the comments, and as long as I see it, I'll put it on the list, and if it's on the list, I will get to it eventually. It's just a matter of having patience. But anyway, I'm digressing once again. This song was excellent. I really like the orchestral elements. I really like the guitar. There was so much going on here, you know? It's like just when, right when you get used to like a certain sound and a certain part of the song, it transitions into a totally different part. And this is just really well done, man. These guys are very talented musicians. And of course, for those who don't know, I'm a huge fantasy fan. And I am a fan of the Wheel of Time series, the books. So I really appreciated these lyrics. And yes, this song is about the series, The Wheel of Time. And I really like that one line about the heroine sword. Wow. Let's start over, shall we? I really... See, I can't talk properly. I told you. I really like that one line about the heron sword, because that's a kind of a focal point of the book, and that's the sword that the protagonist, the main character, Randall Thor, uses. So, you know, they clearly paid attention to detail, and they're clearly fans of the book series, because they've mentioned things that, you know, you kind of have to read the books to know about them. Or it's possible that they just read a synopsis on Wikipedia and, you know, took it from there, but I highly doubt that. These strike me as very well-educated people and very talented and dedicated musicians, so. And I really like their lyrical content. And you could tell they're fantasy fans, too, because they were talking about fantasy stories in the last song, Imaginations, you know. So that really speaks to me, being an aspiring fantasy author myself, being a huge fantasy reader. Yeah, man. There's a lot here, lyrically. So I'm just going to read out a few lines that jump out to me in particular. Lines that I might talk about when I do my analysis. I'm in flames because I have touched the light. It pulls me so. We shall be one forevermore. That's all I want. It's all I need. Everything is fixed. There's no chance. There's no choice. It's calling me. Saidin. So precious and sweet. My mind keeps fading away. There's no end. Wheel of time. It just keeps on spinning. There's no beginning. Turn the wheel of time. Why? I am what I am. Prophecy is I am the chosen. Taveren, the flame will grow. Feel the heat. I'll keep on breathing. After all, there's no tomorrow. The vision, so fleeting and vague. Once again, I will bring down the mountain. One last glimpse. It is constantly slipping away. I cannot erase. I am the dragon reborn. And in madness, I soon shall prevail. Twice I'll be marked, and twice I shall live. The heron sets my path and name me true. Twice I'll be marked, and twice I shall die. My memory is gone, but twice I pay the price. So this song really is about the Wheel of Time series, which is an excellent series, by the way, if you haven't checked it out. I don't know how many fantasy fans and fantasy readers there are in the Nuclear family, but for those of you who are interested, give it at least the first book a read. I mean, I'll say this about it, I'll be fair. The series is definitely cliche to a certain degree, and the way that it treats its female characters in the early books, and to a smaller degree even in the later books, is not something I'm a fan of. But you know, they're doing an adaptation of the book series. I believe it's going to be on Amazon Prime, and they're making the female characters in that show the central ones. So that should be cool to see, you know, really putting the focus on them, because even in the books, they are interesting characters, Egwene and Moiraine, and, you know, it's just like little things with the way they're portrayed by the author I just don't like. So it should be interesting to see what kind of spin they put on the, you know, TV series. But yeah, so I basically see this song as a sort of celebration or retelling of the overall concept of the series. Now, one thing interesting about Wheel of Time is that despite following the typical fantasy and hero's journey mold, it also deals with some interesting metaphysical concepts of duality and reincarnation, for example. And it has some sort of philosophical and spiritual ties with Hinduism in a way, in terms of where it takes or from which it borrows some of its themes and concepts. And the enemy named Shaitan. Yeah, that's pretty much right on the nose, I know. But that name is actually Arabic and is used in Islam to refer to the devil. So there's a lot of variation in terms of the real-world sources that the series pulls from, and that's something I think is cool. But what's cool about this song is that even if you're not a Wheel of Time fan, or even if you're not a fantasy fan, there are themes here that can apply to life. Like, there are existential dilemmas discussed here that bear thinking about, and so you can interpret this in a totally different way if you so choose. Everything is fixed. There's no chance. There's no choice. So even that right there, diverging from the connection to the series just for a moment, let's just talk about that line, because this provokes deep questions about things like human existence or even ethics and morality if you're someone who believes in a higher power and believes that everything is predetermined. And, you know, there's still something about Christianity that makes me itch. Well, there are a few things, but this is one of them, which is the idea that there can be simultaneously free will and the ability to make the decision to either do something that is a moral good or do something that is a sin, when at the same time, there's supposedly a God who controls everything and who knows what always has been and always will be. So it's like, to me, it's very paradoxical, you know, to juxtapose, you know, a predetermined fate with free will, you know? And I have yet to meet someone who can sufficiently explain that to me. So yeah, that's just something I think about from time to time when I think about that religion. Madness creeps in, I'll tear it down. It's calling me, Sidene. So getting back to the books for a minute. For people who don't know what's going on here, the protagonist, Randall Thor, basically is supposed to be the Dragon Reborn, which is like a fancy way of saying that he's the chosen one who's going to stop the big bad. Now, Sidene, or Sidene, however you'd like to pronounce it, is the male aspect of this great power. Almost like the Force in Star Wars, except instead of having a duality of light-dark, you have a duality of male-female. And the male side is Sidene. And, you know, it splits into different types of energy depending on, you know, who's channeling it. I'm actually rereading the series right now, but I'm starting with a prequel book, which is like technically book zero or something, that begins before the Wheel of Time series proper really starts. Actually, I have it right here. I have to get started on it tomorrow. It's called New Spring, and it's like a prequel to the Wheel of Time. So that should be an interesting read. But anyway, interesting that I heard a song about the same series that I'm reading. And that's definitely why I chose this song. It's my second Blind Guardian one to check out. But, you know, I'm actually shocked that I didn't put it together sooner, that if I really gave Power Metal a chance, I'd end up liking it. I mean, so much of it deals with fantasy. And for those who don't know, you know, I love the fantasy genre. I love reading fantasy. I love fantasy series. My big goal is to eventually become a published fantasy author. And here was Power Metal, you know, right in front of me all these years. And teenage me, with my closed mind and my snarky attitude, I would always dismiss it without ever giving it a chance. And I hate that I was like that, man, you know. I'm so glad that I grew up and decided to be more open-minded toward music. Because I gotta say, between the sound of the music I've heard so far and the lyrical content and the fantasy element, I'm really, really starting to develop a love for Power Metal, you know. And I've just barely, you know, set foot on the path of this journey, you know. And I can't wait to continue down this path and do more reactions to bands like this. I've got a couple that I want to check out. There's one band called Sabaton, which I've heard a lot about. Heard those guys were involved in an accident, by the way. I hope they're doing okay. And there's another band called Frozen Crown that someone told me about. So I think those are going to be my next two Power Metal bands to check out. And also, I know they're not technically like pure Power Metal, but I am going to check out more Iced Earth in the near future as well. So look forward to that if you like them. Yeah, man. I really think Blind Guardian, though, might become one of my favorite bands. I mean, this music was really on point. I really dug it. And I always love when a band does a song or even an entire album about a fantasy world or fantasy series. And in a way, most of us metalheads are already used to that because there's such a broad range of bands and genres that have taken influence from and pulled from Tolkien's works. You know, Lord of the Rings and Middle-earth, that whole universe. I mean, it's right in the band names. Amon Amarth, Gorgoroth, Burzum, Khazad-dûm. Major contributor and majorly influential to metal as a whole. And then you have bands that have based their music around more obscure fantasy series like Malazan and Book of the Fallen. And you have bands like Skagos, which is literally named after a little-known island in the Game of Thrones books. So, and then you have a band like this, which did a whole song about the Wheel of Time. And I find that incredibly awesome. And of course it helps that the lyrics were on point and the music itself was very excellent. But after thinking about it and kind of processing it in my head a little bit and doing my analysis, I believe that I like Imaginations from the Other Side slightly more than I like this one. But I still really, really love this one, as you guys, I'm sure, saw as I was reacting. So I'm going to give this one an 11 out of 12 on the Doomsday Clock. A very strong 11. So there you have it. I guess this was kind of a self-indulgent reaction, but I think I need to do one of those every once in a while. And I really like this band. And yes, I am revisiting them pretty quickly after doing the first reaction, but I was just feeling it. I really wanted to hear more from these guys, and I wanted to share it with you guys. So I hope you enjoy the reaction. And for those of you who have requests sitting on the infinite list, and they're still sitting there while I'm doing, you know, reactions like this, things that I pick, I really want to thank you for your patience. Just know that I really am dedicated to that list and to you guys and your requests. And I'm really working on powering through that backlog there and getting to some more of those in the days to come. But that's about it for this video. So I hope everyone's doing well. Thank you so much for the support. Thank you for subscribing. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do. It's worth it. Trust me. And I will catch you guys on the next one.